I apologize for the delay in the release of this video. I've had a cold, so my voice is a little off. I appreciate your patience as I kind of work through this. If any of you have been to this location, I would love to hear any creepy stories you might have. Today's location is one that's well known, as it's a staple of historic 25th Street in Ogden. Many locals recognize it today as the Bigelow or Ben Lomond Hotel. But did you know that wasn't even the name of the original hotel? Built in 1891, it was originally known as the Reed Hotel. When it was initially built, it was only a 5-story building. The tall 13-story structure seen today wouldn't come until 1927, when it would be rebranded as the Bigelow Hotel and additional stories were added to it. And let me tell you, most of the tragedies and deaths tied to this hotel are found under the Reed name. But we'll get to those. First, let me tell you the ghost stories associated with the hotel. The most famous story is that of a second-time bride-to-be who was set to be married at the hotel. The night before the wedding, she drowned in the bathtub of room 1102. There's speculation if this was deliberate or simply a tragic accident. Her son came to the hotel to collect her belongings and, overcome with grief, decided to end his life. It's said he jumped out of the window in the hallway just outside of room 1101. Other stories come out of room 1106, where it's said the spirits of two brothers have been seen and heard. And lastly is said to be the spirit of a woman who starved herself to death after learning of her son's demise in a train accident on the way home from the war. I searched extensively to try to find any articles that may have added some credibility to these stories, but I couldn't find any. That doesn't necessarily mean that they aren't true, it just means I couldn't find any proof to corroborate them. The other thing that makes me speculative of the authenticity of the claims is the fact that I've spent quite a bit of time in room 1101. While I admit it had an eerie, almost being watched air to it, nothing strange happened in the 2 weeks my husband had to stay in that room while doing work in the building. We never heard noises coming from room 1102. In fact, all the weird happenings took place in the basement. For background, my husband was on fire watch while they replaced the fire system in the building. When on fire watch, he was required to walk the entirety of the building to make sure no fires had broken out. This included walking through the basement and tunnels still existing down there. He often heard noises coming from the rooms he'd just walked through, where he knew no one was there. Mind you, the residents of this building don't have access to the areas of the basement where the weird things happened. The other strange thing that would happen was with the elevator. There's a particular elevator that many have reported opening on its own. I can say this one did that. Again, strangely enough, usually when in the basement, when no one was around. That's not to say there wasn't any sort of explanation behind why it does that, it simply added to the strange ambiance of the basement. So with that, let's dive into this one. There's a lot of tragedy to unpack here. In doing my research of the Reed Hotel, numerous deaths came up, which will happen with old buildings. But there were many tragic ones, including a cook, 34-year-old Harry McComa, who fell 3 stories down a freight elevator shaft and died. Not long before, there had been a similar incident with the freight elevator, which resulted in another man losing both of his legs. However, he survived this ordeal. A man by the name of Adolf Schweitzer, who was suffering from delusion, nearly decapitated himself with a cheap pocket knife, but was fortunately saved before he bled out. Mrs. Van Allen, who had been struggling with her mental health, used a revolver to end her own life. Her husband discovered her in her apartment at the hotel. D. Sepser, a painter who fell 50 feet from scaffolding, he did in fact survive, thankfully. A man named Isidore Welsh, who accidentally ingested a fatal amount of laudanum. Tom Washima, who had attempted to murder a woman named Nellie Cohn, and then ended his own life. and finally a swindler named Leonard Karlstedt, who was on the verge of being apprehended when he also ended his own life. It's worth noting that at the time of the Reed Hotel, 25th Street had an abundance of transient activity as it was near Union Station and the railway. This can explain some of the chaotic ongoings within the hotel. By 1927, the hotel fell under new ownership, and with it came the name Bigelow Hotel. The new owners wanted it to be a grand and luxurious hotel and added 8 more stories to the building. The only notable death during this time was the death of Major Armand Mechin, a veteran of 3 wars, who had become despondent and decided to take an anesthetic, ultimately leading to his demise. By 1933, the Bigelow was struggling financially, so it changed hands once again, this time being renamed to the Ben Lomond Hotel. With the name change came more tragic deaths. A 40-year-old woman named Donna Anderson, who authorities weren't sure if she fell or leapt to her death from the 9th story. 2 men, 29-year-old Glenn Jackson and 32-year-old Elmo Chapman, jumped from the 13th floor. The men's bodies struck the roof of an adjoining building. Glenn died on impact. Unfortunately for Elmo, he didn't pass away until he was en route to the nearby hospital. So now that you know the background, you can understand why the eerie atmosphere makes a lot more sense. Today, you can rent an apartment at the Bigelow Suites, or even have your wedding events there. I have to say, the main lobby and the grand ballroom really do make you feel like you're stepping back in time. And for that, I really loved this building.